morning, children. In the last class, we have discussed about crop production and management. That is first chapter. And in that chapter, we have discussed about steps involved in the agricultural practice. In today's class, we will learn a second chapter, that is about microorganisms. The name of the chapter is Microorganisms, Friends and Foes. I think you heard about the word microorganisms. Then friends and foes. That means microorganisms are our friends and as well as foes means they are enemies. Microorganisms are friends as well as enemies in different ways. That we have to discuss in this chapter. How the microorganisms are friends for us as well as how the microorganisms are enemies or foe. Now, first of all, we have to discuss about what are microorganisms. You already studied about the meaning of microorganisms. Microorganisms are the organism. They cannot be seen with the help of naked eye, but can be seen only with the help of microscope. They are very small in size. Naked eye is also called as unaided eye. Unaided eye means what? Barigannu. Barigannu in the nodlike agodila. These organisms are called as microorganisms. Microorganisms are too small, means very small, and are not visible to the unaided eye. What is the definition of microorganism? Microorganisms are too small and are not visible to the unaided eye. They are very small in size and they cannot be seen with the help of naked eye or unaided eye. That is the definition of microorganism. This microorganism can be seen with the help of magnifying glass. Some of the microorganisms can be seen with the help of magnifying glass. But some of the microorganisms you cannot see with the help of magnifying glass. You should go through microscope. With the help of microscope, you can observe some of the microorganisms. Our day-to-day life, you will come across some of the microorganisms. If you keep bread in moist place, there will be a development of a fungus. That is also an example for microorganism. There is a development of bread mold. And so many bacteria in the water, you will come across some of the microorganisms. There are different types of microorganisms you will come across. These can be seen with the help of microscope or with the help of magnifying glass. These microorganisms are classified based on the shape, structure, size. Based on that, they are classified into four major groups. Based on the shape, size, structure, microorganisms are classified into four major groups. What are those four major groups of microorganism? First one is very important, bacteria. Second one is fungi. Third one is protozoans. And fourth one is algae. These are the four major groups of microorganisms. Bacteria, fungi, protozoa, as well as algae. Earlier, there are five major groups. That was virus. That virus was added in that group. But now it was taken out from the group of that microorganism. They are not included under the group of microorganism because of some reason. Viruses are microscopic. They are very small. They are also microscopic. They are microscopic or microorganisms. But they are not grouped under the microorganism because of some reason. Because they are also microscopic but are different from other microorganisms. I told that one. They reproduce only inside the host organism where they will live, there only they are having the capacity to reproduce. Outside that organism, they are not showing the capacity of reproduction. Inside that host body, they will reproduce. They may be inside the bacterium, they may be inside the plant body, or they may be inside the animal body. They are considered as host for viruses. Where they will live, that is considered as a host body. You studied about the meaning of host body in the 7th standard. Viruses are microscopic, but they are not grouped under the microorganism group because they are different from those microorganisms. They reproduce only inside the host body. These viruses, they cause some of the diseases. They are also microscopic. They will cause some of the diseases. You heard common diseases caused by viruses. They are cold, common cold, influenza, flu, polio, chicken pox, etc. These are the some of the diseases caused by the viruses. Next, the bacteria, protozoa, all they will cause some of the diseases in the body of animals or body of human being. What are those diseases? You studied about some of the diseases. They, for example, you consider protozoa, first of all. Okay. Protozoa, it causes a disease. You heard about that disease. That is amoebic dysentery. That amoebic dysentery is caused by the protozoa. Name is Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica, that is a protozoa that causes amoebic dysentery. Next, another one, this is caused by protozoa, that is malaria. Malaria disease that is caused by protozoa, name of that protozoa is Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax that causes malaria disease, not by the mosquito. That Anopheles female mosquito, that is a carrier of this protozoa. Okay, carrier of this disease. And bacteria that causes a disease called as typhoid. Bacteria that causes disease typhoid as well as tuberculosis. Tuberculosis disease also caused by the bacteria. These are the some of the diseases caused by the different types of microorganism. That's why microorganisms are considered as a foes or enemies, because they cause us some of the diseases. These microorganisms may be single cellular or multicellular. Some of the microorganisms are having single cell, that's why they are called as unicellular. Some of the microorganisms are made up of many cells, that's why they are called as multicellular. Examples for unicellular organism, they are bacteria, algae and protozoa. And some of the microorganisms, they are multicellular, example algae and fungi. These are the examples for multicellular organism. These organisms or microorganisms, they may be present in all type of environment. They exist in all type of environment. It may be from a cold climatic condition to dry climatic condition. Even in desert also, you will come across this microorganism. That is a living place of microorganism. They live in all types of environment, ranging from ice cold climate to hot springs. Microorganism, I told, they are considered as friends because of some reason. They are helpful in some of the activities. And first of all, microorganisms are considered as they help in cleaning the environment. You know that some of the waste materials that are present in the environment, they are decomposed by the bacteria as well as other microorganisms. They help to convert that into manure. Thereby, they reduce the waste in the environment. Thereby, they clean the environment. That is very important. Now, they are considered as friendly microorganisms. That means microorganism help in cleaning the environment. Next one, they help in these microorganisms. They help in the preparation of some of the medicine as well as alcohol. In the preparation of alcohol, in the medicine, they are helpful. We will discuss in detail all these useful. And next, microorganism, they help in agricultural field. Thereby, in agriculture, they help to increase the fertility of the soil. That means the rhizobium bacteria that is present in the soil bacteria that is present in the root nodules of leguminous plant, they help in the nitrogen fixation. Thereby, they increase the fertility of the soil. And next, they help in making curd as well as bread. They help in the preparation of curd as well as bread. These are the other some of the uses you will study in detail in the next class. These are the micro uses of microorganism. Because of these uses or these importance of microorganism, they are considered as friendly microorganism. Some of the microorganisms are our friends, some of the microorganisms are our foe. Foe means what? Enemies. Because they cause some of the diseases in our body. Sometimes they will ask why microorganisms are friends as well as foes. That's a very common question they will ask. Just because of this reason. I think you understood what are the major groups of microorganism and classification of microorganism and the living place of microorganism and what is the meaning of microorganism as well as why they are considered as friendly microorganism or they are considered as foe. Okay, this is about the introduction to the chapter that is microorganism and microorganism, friends and foes. In the next class, we'll discuss in detail about the friendly microorganism. Next, we discuss about the diseases caused by the microorganism. And you refer the textbook in the microorganism chapter second page. In that you will come across some of the diagrams related to the microorganism. You go through that and try to practice those diagrams in the rough book. And one thing I want to tell you that complete the exercise question and answer if possible. I mean, I think some of the questions are repeated. Almost all the questions are repeated in the extra question what I have given. But you complete other question answers. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Thank you.